Jadi kalau sebelumnya orang masih lihat image, still image gitu kan, semakin ke sini, semakin ke hari ini ya, itu tuh konten video memang jauh-jauh lebih digemari. Oke, nah ini sebelum kita mulai, saya coba play video dulu ya.
There's a lot going on Instagram right now. We're experimenting with a number of different changes to the app. And so we're hearing a lot of concerns from all of you. So I wanted to take a few moments and clarify a few things. One is, if you're seeing a new full screen version of a feed, or you're hearing about it, know that that is a test. It's a test to a few percentage of people out there, and the idea is that a more full screen experience, not only for videos, but for photos, might be a more fun, engaging experience. But I also want to be clear, it's not yet good, and we're going to have to get it to a good place if we're going to ship it to the rest of the Instagram community. The second thing I'm hearing a lot of concerns about right now are photos and how we're shifting to video. Now, I want to be clear. We're going to continue to support photos. It's part of our heritage. You know, I love photos. I know a lot of you out there love photos too. That said, I need to be honest. I do believe that more and more of Instagram is going to become video over time. We see this even if we change nothing. We see this even if you just look at chronological feed. If you look at what people share on Instagram, that's shifting more and more to videos over time. If you look at what people like and consume and view on Instagram, that's also shifting more and more to video over time, even when we stop changing anything. So we're going to have to lean into that shift while continuing to support photos. The third thing I want to talk about is recommendations.
Oh, sorry. Putus kayaknya. Bentar.
There's a lot going on Instagram right now. We're experimenting with a number of different changes to the app. And so we're hearing a lot of concerns from all of you. So I wanted to take a few moments and clarify a few things. One is, if you're seeing a new full screen version of a feed, or you're hearing about it, know that that is a test. It's a test to a few percentage of people out there, and the idea is that a more full screen experience, not only for videos, but for photos, might be a more fun, engaging experience. But I also want to be clear, it's not yet good. And we're going to have to get it to a good place if we're going to ship it to the rest of the Instagram community. The second thing I'm hearing a lot of concerns about right now are photos and how we're shifting to video. Now, I want to be clear. We're going to continue to support photos. It's part of our heritage. You know, I love photos. I know a lot of you out there love photos too. That said, I need to be honest. I do believe that more and more of Instagram is going to become video over time. We see this even if we change nothing. We see this even if you just look at chronological feed. If you look at what people share on Instagram, that's shifting more and more to videos over time. If you look at what people like and consume and view on Instagram, that's also shifting more and more to video over time, even when we stop changing anything. So we're going to have to lean into that shift while continuing to support photos. The third thing I want to talk about is recommendations. Recommendations are posts in your feed from accounts that you do not follow. The idea is to help you discover new and interesting things on Instagram that you might not know even exist. Now, if you're seeing things in your feed that are recommendations that you're not interested in, that means that we're doing a bad job ranking and we need to improve. And you can X out a recommendation. You can even snooze all recommendations for up to a month or go to your following feed. But we're going to continue to try and get better at recommendations because we think it's one of the most effective and important ways to help creators reach more people. We want to do our best by creators, particularly small creators, and we see recommendations as one of the best ways to help them reach a new audience and grow their following. Now, this is a lot of change all at once, but know that a number of things about Instagram are going to stay the same. We're going to stay committed to creators more broadly. We're going to stay committed to supporting photos. We're going to stay in a place where we try and put your friends' content at the top of feed and the front of stories whenever possible. But we're also going to need to evolve because the world is changing quickly and we're going to have to change along with it. So please let me know what you think down in the comments and know that I'm going to continue to be here explaining our changes as we come up with them, the reasoning behind them, and give you the latest updates about what's going on Instagram. I'll see you soon. Peace.
Oke, jadi video ini dari Moseri. Moseri ini director of Instagram. Jadi mungkin aku highlight aja 3 poin penting dari dia. Dia menginformasikan kalau misalnya untuk konten, itu saat ini yang paling update adalah nggak lagi foto. Foto masih eksis, tapi kedepannya bakal banyak konten-konten video. gitu. Terus kemudian nggak cuma konten video, tapi konten video yang fun dan entertaining, dan juga ada recommendation di situ. Jadi hopefully kita hari ini bisa juga belajar juga gimana caranya untuk bikin kreasi konten yang bentuknya video. Jadi hari ini bakal kita bahas banyak tentang konten video, terus kemudian yang fun entertaining itu gimana, dan yang terakhir yang typical recommendation konten itu kayak gimana sih. Oke, jadi kita introduction dengan insight tadi, sedikit insight dari CEO Instagram, lalu ini ada insight juga kalau misalnya sekarang online video will make up more than 82% of all consumer internet traffic. Jadi kalau sebelumnya orang masih lihat image, still image gitu kan, semakin ke sini, semakin ke hari ini ya, itu tuh konten video memang jauh-jauh lebih digemari gitu. Terus ini salah satu insight juga, 50% millennials and Gen Z itu sudah di-reset nih kalau misalnya mereka juga cannot cannot live without video in their daily life gitu. Jadi kalau kita sekarang sehari-hari, terutama teman-teman content creator nih, pasti pagi-pagi udah scroll Instagram, scroll TikTok, terus lihat ada video apa hari ini, bla 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 gitu. Jadi memang kita sudah sangat awam lah dengan, sudah sangat familiar ya dengan konten-konten video. Oke. Itu sedikit insight dari dari saya, dari oleh karena itu hari ini kita bakal fokus ke itu introduction ya, buat advertisernya aja. Ini kita mau fokus ke gimana caranya untuk video production nih, strateginya kayak gimana sih. Nah, ini ada beberapa poin yang bakal teman-teman pelajarin hari ini. Jadi kita bakal start dengan video goals kita seperti apa, terus kemudian gimana caranya kita menemukan target audience kita, terus figure out juga story apa yang kita mau ceritain, terus kemudian gimana caranya kita keep kreatif, memenuhi inilah keinginan audience, terus bagaimana kita bisa ngatur timeline kita, dan kemudian buat realistic budget ya, gitu. Tapi mungkin kita bakal banyak bahas di poin-poin atas kayak gitu. Karena hari ini kita kan fokusnya lebih ke content creation. Oke, kalau video production sendiri, aku cepat saja dibagi jadi tiga hal. Jadi pertama pre-production, itu ada goals, ada audience, type video seperti apa, cara buat storyboard seperti apa, terus kemudian production dan post-production. Hari ini kita bakal banyak fokus ke pre-production-nya. Jadi kalau untuk production dan post-production, saya yakin teman-teman di sini udah sangat familiar. Nah, kita lebih banyak bahas di pre-production karena sebenarnya itu 70-80% pentingnya itu tuh di pre-production. 15%-nya di production dan post-production-nya 15%. Seperti itu.